Today the maximum chance is for you to speak. Today being the last day, lot of time will be there. Yesterday we didn't have enough time. So let us complete the exercises quickly, and then if 1 hour or 1.5 hours are left, it'll be very good for your practice. Okay? So today's item is informal and formal English. Throughout I have been telling you how to use informal and formal English. Because what we use in an informal context is not correct in a formal context. Then people feel that you don't know English if you use informal English for formal context. So you have to be very careful. I told you all short forms are not used like that, some sentences. Then also correction, because many times mistakes are made. Just now I got a mail, somebody says that, is this sentence active voice or passive voice? If it is passive, how to change to active? If it is active, how to change to passive? Now this much grammar does not help you to speak English. Please remember, you might know perfectly active voice, passive voice, changing them, but you might not know how to use English. So don't get worried about those things. Some basic rules, if you know, that is enough. So that way I have given a few slides for the correction aspect, how to correct sentences. So let us start with the informal and formal variety. Now you see it is written on top, the informal variety, and at the bottom the formal variety. So one after another the sentences are given. Now these words like gonna and wanna have become very popular today. Like yesterday somebody says, you guys learn English. You can't say that in a classroom because that is a formal context. You can say all of you, or you can say students, some such thing, but not you guys. You guys is an informal usage. Similarly, when you are talking to your superiors, you're talking to your boss, you say, I'm gonna, that is not correct. That is the American influence on all of you. Very good. It makes your English sound excellent, but informal, not formal. In formal context, we don't use it. Somebody writes a mail saying, I want to be an English teacher. So I replied by saying, first, to become an English teacher, stop saying, I want to be an English teacher to a stranger like me. You don't know me. You are writing a mail to me. You know that I'm a person who has been teaching English. So it is a formal relationship between you and me. Don't say, I want to teach English. First you learn. After that, no reply came back. Then I said, don't use informal English. Because we like to use informal. We think we are very stylish, that our English is very excellent if we use these words. Every time I find the use. First you learn traditional, correct, formal English. Only then you learn informal English, half English, SMS English, WhatsApp English. All that is only second phase. First phase is standard, good, traditional, full formal English. Once you learn that, you can learn any variety of English. That is why I have put these slides. These slides have some ideas which we use informally. They are not correct or wrong. Please understand, all of them are correct sentences, but they are used differently. Let us read them. I hope you will notice each of the examples, find out which is informal and which is formal, and use accordingly. Okay? So please repeat one by one. I'm only going to read the blue colored ones. Okay? That is the formal ones, because we are talking now about formal English. I'm not reading the informal ones. Already all of you have these slides. You can use them. Anybody who's watching your videos also, please give them all this PowerPoint presentation. I don't want to keep it with me. 1,000 are watching, then 1,000 people can get it. Okay? please circulate that also. You put it up, that will be fine. Now, when we say I gonna learn English, what the correct form is? I am going to learn English. Please repeat. I want to teach. Please go away. Or please leave.
Please leave.
Okay? Then I respect that person.
I respect that person.
I respect that gentleman.
I respect that gentleman.
I respect that lady.
I respect that lady.
That is how it is. You know, the formal usage, not the word guy. Guy can be used for anybody, but only informal. Now, some children, kids also is an informal usage. We don't use it. Actually, the word pig, if you look at the dictionary, it means a small goat, not a small human being. So, we are using it informally, kid for small child. But that is not a human child at all. Formally, it means a child of some animal. That is the goat. So, we use, for human beings, we use it informally, but never formally. We do not want to do this work anymore. Here, don't is full form. Here. And see, two negatives are there. We don't want to do no more implies that it is double negative. So we don't use double negatives. That is an informal usage. Very often, people whose mother tongue is English, but who have no education, you know, like Telugu, people who, educated people speak Telugu, uneducated people speak Telugu, you have different versions. So that is called dialect. So that is a dialect form where you have double negative. That is a mother tongue English form. We don't use it because we are not learning English as a mother tongue. Yes, we have to say any more instead of, yes, we can't say no more. No more is the informal usage. Only in spoken English, that too, people who are using English as their mother tongue, who don't know very good standard English, use that. If you get a chance, all of you should see a movie called My Fair Lady. It's an old movie. It's called My Fair Lady. It is about learning English. One student who had asked about pronunciation. You know, it is a very good movie for pronunciation. Because the professor is teaching one girl who sells flowers. She used to sell flowers on the road. Her English is bad, although it's her mother tongue. But bad English. So he says, oh, I will change her and make her speak like an educated lady. And he takes up this challenge. So there's a beautiful song which says, the rind and spine falls mindly on the plains. That is how she pronounces. Actually, it should be, the rain in Spain falls mainly on the plains. So wherever A is there, like I told you yesterday, available, not available. Did you understand? Very often mistake is made. The same mistake I repeated just now. The rain in spine is I sound, which is actually rain, A sound. So this A, I sound is very often made mistake. That movie, if you, all of you see, you will learn a lot about teaching and learning English. It's a very nice movie. I'm sure you'll be able to enjoy that. She has gone to the next village. Look at the contraction, she's. She's, we don't know whether it means she is or she has. The same contraction is used, she apostrophe S. So, it can be is also, it can be has also. So, actually here, the formal English tells you what exactly it is. These are not what we asked for. May I leave now? Now, can is capability. If you say, can I leave now? That means, can you get up from the chair? Can you walk to the door? Can you go out of the door? Capability. But may means permission. So you can see, Very often, informally, we use can or may. But when we want to use formal English, may is the correct form here for asking permission, not can. Informally, can be used. See, question. The question form also, I didn't put it, I'll just tell you. Are you coming? That's a question. But very often we don't say are in front. We put the same intonation and say, you are coming? You are coming is a statement. We are raising the intonation and making it into a question. Informally, it is correct. Informally, no problem. We can say that. But when we are saying formally, then the verb comes in front and we, instead of saying you are coming, we say are you coming? That is the difference. So this is the difference between formal and informal. Many proposals were received on the last day. See, at the nick of time, etc., we use only in our daily conversations. This is an official one. You can easily make out by this sentence that it's an official communication. Usually in official communication, we make use of the passive forms. So here we have made the passive form. I have much work to do today. Could you please buy yourself a vehicle? Could you please purchase a vehicle? So, I've put a slash there, two possible sentences are there. Now, mistakes, now we come to common mistakes which we make. How we are going to correct them? The sentence which is on top is the sentence where something is wrong. You can see it is underlined also. And the correct sentences only we shall read. Okay? The formal dress code is trousers. You can see how the S is there. Although it is only one, you know, only one person can wear it. But it is called trousers. It's not called trouser. That is the usage. I want to buy a pair of pants. Again, it means one only. It doesn't mean two. Pair of pants, if you say, it actually means what one person wears. Because it has two divisions like that, we are calling it as a pair. This room has too much furniture. One day I told you that, you know, we have countable, uncountable nouns. Furniture is an uncountable noun. Even if you have 100 pieces, you will call it only furniture. If you have one, you call furniture. If you have 100, you call furniture also. Sometimes singular and plural are the same. Like sheep, S-H-E-E-P, it's the name of an animal from which we get wool. You know, if we wear sweaters and coats and all, that wool comes from an animal called sheep. So sheep doesn't have plural sheeps. One is also called sheep, more than one is also called sheep. So like that we have to remember, that's not an uncountable noun, that is singular plural form is the same. Then, can you give me a glass of milk? We went to buy some bottles of oil. We went to buy some varieties of oil. We don't say oils, we don't say one milk, because these are all not possible to count. You can't count one milk, two milks like that. Therefore, we have to put some other noun which can be counted. Now here you have, the word monies has a different meaning. Suppose you are putting money from different sources and together in one place, then you can use the word monies. But money which belongs to one person, one account, one family, one resource, it is always called money, it's not called monies. They have money in the bank. He wants to open a school for the poor. One person poor, more than one person also poor. Group of people, poor, not poors. we don't have the form as plural poors. Poor is an uncountable noun. We want a pair of scissors to cut the cloth. So you can see scissor, we don't say, we say a pair of scissors. We don't say scissors also, we say a pair of scissors. Now, I want cheese and a slice of bread for breakfast. Now see, a cheese and a bread is where you are using it wrongly. Wealth helps a person to be generous. Wealth helps a person in generosity. Now generosities, we don't have only generosity. Now how the subject and the verb should be together. If the subject is singular, we have to use singular verb. If the subject is plural, we have to use plural verb. Singular verb is a verb with S and plural verb is a verb without S. It is exactly opposite to nouns, where nouns, if you add S, they become plural. Verb, if you add S, it becomes singular. Do you understand? That is called concord or agreement, subject-verb agreement. Now the word news, although it looks like a plural, news is a singular noun. So we always use singular verb for that. Do you think the news is false?
Do you think that news is false?
The leader and the team members,
the leader and the team members,
seem to agree.
Seem to agree.
Now see, the leader and team members are more than one person. So that is why we use the plural verb. Plural verb is without S. If you say seems, that becomes singular. If singular subject, singular verb. Here is not a singular subject, therefore we say seem. No one is welcome.
No one is welcome here.
I forgot. No one is welcome here.
No one is welcome here.
So R becomes is. For no one, always singular. Either you or your friend,
either you or your friend,
wins the prize.
Wins the prize.
Here, although there are two people, you are there, your friend is also there, but or is there. Or means this or this. So it becomes singular. Suppose both the nouns were plural, then you would use win. But both nouns are singular. You have to choose one of them. Therefore, wins is correct, that is a singular verb. Now the last line, red color, is not correct. It should have been green. So that is the correct word. Prefers is correct. He and not his sister,
he and not his sister,
prefers the safari.
Prefers the safari.
Okay, there it is correct sentence. It's not red, it should have been green. Now, very often we make mistakes in the use of article. Where article should be used, we don't use an article. Where article, definite article should be used, we use indefinite article. Where indefinite article should be used, we use no article or definite article. So therefore, we need to know where to use. Again and again, I've been telling you from the first day till today, that the best way of learning is by being conscious when you use the language. So tomorrow when you read the newspaper, I hope you read some English newspaper every day. Try to do it, because if you want to read the news, read the Telugu newspaper. If you want to learn English, then after finishing reading all the news or listening to all the news in Telugu, then you read the paper for the benefit of your English. Suppose you buy one paper, it has 20 pages, then for 20 days you don't have to buy another paper. Or for 1 month you don't have to buy a paper. Because so many columns are there, so much English is there. Each day you read that much. So for 2-3 months, one paper is enough. That paper you keep carefully, read again and again. You read 5 sentences and see where articles are used, how they are used, where they are not used, and so on. Articles do the same function as adjectives. They come in front of a noun, they talk about the noun. So sometimes we need it, sometimes we don't need it. Here you see, I have given you some examples. Read only the second sentence, the sentences below. Okay. Parents want their children to study in good schools. Whenever you have been speaking here or there, you have been making many mistakes in articles. I could not correct all those mistakes because that is difficult. Then I have to stop you every minute. You will feel self-conscious. You will lose your confidence. So I allowed you to speak. But when you record and listen, you should be able to find out, okay, I made a mistake in the use of article. That much you have to learn. That much you have to practice in order to benefit. So the good schools, we don't say, we say good schools without article, because this is the basic purpose which we are using. I live in a quiet locality.
I live in a quiet locality.
In the city. So the has become a here. That means many quiet localities are there. One of them we are using. There is a bank. Near my house. Where I have an account. Now see, both the bank has become a bank and only account has become an account. I remember the toy. I had. When I was five. Do you have a friend? In school. He spent an hour. In a university.
In the university.
He spent an hour. In a university. University is again pronounced with ya. So I'm saying a university. Here you can use the also. So he spent an hour in the university. He spent an hour. In the university. I'm saying the university because we are pronouncing consonant sound. We are writing a vowel sound U, but we are pronouncing it as university. We are not pronouncing as university. Suppose we say university, then it would be all right. But we are not saying that. We are saying university. So there difference is there. Then we have in adjective, the use of some is always for positive sentences. Any is used for negative sentences. So wherever the meaning is negative, use any. Wherever the meaning is positive, use some. Some means small quantity, any means small quantity. Remember, we did adjectives of quantity, so that some, any comes under adjective of quantity. But here we don't know how much the quantity is. Much, many, big quantity, little, few, small quantity. This is indefinite quantity. Some means there is a quantity, but we cannot say how much. So I have put sentences where there is interchange of some and any so that I will read only the correct sentences. I can give you some advice. I cannot give you any advice. May I ask you some questions? You may cannot ask me any questions. Do you have some time? I do not have any time. So notice how some and any are used in the positive and negative forms. Now, again, another point which we make many mistakes is the use of preposition. So the wrong preposition is already underlined in the sentence, and we will read only the sentences where the right preposition is used. Once you go home, you please analyze and see. Those of you who are planning to practice from tomorrow will make use of these slides. I cannot say everybody will practice, because from Monday I am saying please practice. I think you are relaxing a little. I cannot find fault with any of you because summer is very hot in Hyderabad this year. Therefore, take some rest. Once the rain comes in June, start learning English along with nice rain, good English. Okay, you be comfortable and start learning. This PowerPoint is already there with all of you. Look at this, try to understand where you make mistakes and then use this as the document to test whether your mistakes you can correct. We shall meet in the evening or at night. We don't say in the night, in the morning, in the afternoon, in the evening, at night. So four parts of the day, all are in except night, which is at. I am looking for a place
to sit.
See, yesterday I told you sometimes we use extra preposition, sometimes we don't use preposition at all. So here preposition was not used. Looking a place is not correct. Looking for a place. Whereas going to home is not correct. Going home. Working in abroad, I told you, remember? You have used these sentences yesterday. So once we hear the correct sentence, we should go on practicing it for 1 month, 2 months, 5 months, every day 2-3 times. Then only we will learn. Suppose you see it once correct and wrong, I'm showing you on the slide, you say, oh, I learnt English. That's not going to happen. You have to practice every day, at night. You go on making 100 sentences. I eat dinner at night, the moon comes out at night, I can talk to my friend on the telephone at night. Make 100 sentences, always saying at night. Then you will get the benefit. Then you will have better English. Unless you do like that, you won't get it. I hope when Bharat puts all this on the YouTube, he will call it as language drill and not as spoken English, because what I am teaching you is not spoken English. What I am teaching you is language drill. Unless you do it personally, unless you go on repeating, how much ever practice you do for spoken English, you join 1 month course or 6 month course, you don't get benefit. They'll charge you thousands of rupees. That's what I'm told. I don't know what they charge, but I'm told that it's quite a lot of money. After spending that money, you write to me a mail saying, Madam, we didn't learn anything. We joined many courses. Now tell us how to improve. The key for improvement is inside you. You have to find that key. Don't look around the whole world by saying, where is English? English is inside. All you have to do is to bring it out so that you are able to learn. Okay? Then, I'm looking for a place to sit. Two is necessary. I'm listening to music. This mistake is made by everybody, including those who know very good English. They say, I'm listening music, I'm listening song, I'm listening this. Listen is a verb which cannot take immediately noun. It is not a transitive verb at all. Therefore, we have to put preposition. The only way you can add a noun to an intransitive word is by putting a preposition. And therefore, I'm listening to music. To listen, always listen to. I listen to my parents, I listen to elders. Always listen comes with to. She worked here for many years. Suppose it was has worked, then since would be all right. But since it is only worked, we say for. The tree is beside the river. Besides has different meaning. Although only S is there, meaning is different. So, beside means side by side. It is here, then by the side of it something is there, we say beside, by the side of. Besides means extra, in addition to. So, besides learning English, we have to learn 2-3 other languages. I told you in the first class, the more languages you learn, the sharper your mind will be. You don't have to play memory games. You don't have to do anything. Learn new languages. Your mind will become very sharp, very healthy, very good. So learning English is not only good for your job. Learning English is good for your mental health also. Isn't it nice? So we have to do that. She has to move to this city.
She has moved to this city.
In 2018. Okay, she has moved, it is. Please read again. She has moved to this city.
She has moved to this city.
In 2018. They have been living here.
They have been living here.
Since April. Now see, you have earlier since was wrong. Here since is correct. Because the tense is with have. Perfect tenses always use the word since. If exact time is mentioned, April is mentioned. So that exact mention makes it always since. Pour the tea into the cup.
Pour the tea into the cup.
In means already it is there. Into means movement. If there is movement, then we say into. Okay, now among is not correct. That should have been red. It became green. Now, the correct one is there was a fight between two groups.
There was a fight between two groups.
Suppose you want to use among, then you say there was a fight between many groups. If many people are there, we use among. If two are there, we use between. One and two, between. More than two, three, four, five, six, then it becomes among. Both are correct words, but usage is problem. Now verbs, misuse of verbs. We have studied a lot of verbs. Now some. You were asked to speak at the meeting.
You were asked to speak at the meeting.
Very many times we say you was. You is not, never was. I gave you the whole chart of which pronoun goes with what. Did you understand the question?
Did you understand the question?
Already did is past tense. So no verb should have any tense anymore. One verb in the sentence can have tense. So understood is past tense, did is past tense. We can't use two times past tense. So if one past tense is there, the rest of it will become ordinary. These are called infinitive forms. The verb is infinitive. That means no tense form is there. We did not buy lunch.
We did not buy lunch.
Does he bring lunch?
Does he bring lunch?
He may lose the election.
He lose the election.
See, this is a spelling also. We often think L-O-S-E, L-O-S-O-S-E is same. L-O-S-E lose means something is gone. Whereas L-O-O-S-E means it is not tight. Opposite of tight is L with two O's. So that is meaning change is also there. Are you going to the market?
Are you going to the market?
Okay. Now, words sometimes are misused. So we have here a list of them. Notice the spellings. Many of them are spelling punctuation mistakes. So if you look at the wrong sentence, you will easily find what correction we have made. The carpenters want their wages.
The carpenters want their wages.
Now, T-H-E-R-E is also pronounced there. T-H-E-I-R is also pronounced there. So when you are speaking, no problem is there. It's only when you are writing that the problem comes and you have to put it rightly. Is this your handkerchief?
Is this your handkerchief?
Now again, see, pronunciation is same. Y-O-U apostrophe R-E is also pronounced as your. Y-O-U-R is also pronounced as your. But apostrophe form is not there because that means you are. Your means you are. So here we don't need you are, we need your. It's raining heavily.
It's raining heavily.
My umbrella has its handle missing.
My umbrella has its handle missing.
Now notice, ITS is the possessive form of which is a pronoun. IT apostrophe S is it is. It is short form is IT apostrophe S. So both of them have different function. So we say it is raining heavily. That is what we want to say. Not it is handle missing. It is handle missing is not possible. That's not English at all. Therefore, that correction is made. Here are again two words which are pronounced exactly the same, but spelling is different. The principal of our college is a man of principles.
Is a man of principles.
AL is for the person in charge, and LE is for some rules, some values, then some ideas. We say principal, PL. We came here to hear the news.
We came here to hear the good news.
Again, you see, here H-E-R-E, H-E-A-R, same pronunciation. All these have no problem while speaking. Spoken English, nobody can make out it's a mistake. It's only when you write that the mistakes come. Then if you write, because many of you have to write also, just speaking is not enough. You have to write. Then if you make mistakes, then your English becomes bad. With that, we come to the end of the PowerPoint presentations. Now it is all your turn. We have an hour and 15 minutes. Our hero hasn't come. Where is the group discussion?